Hey, and welcome back to my channel. If you are new to this channel is all about showing you guys inspiring vegan and plant-based recipes that are hopefully quick and easy for busy families. Today, we are actually going to be doing an Aldi grocery haul. I'm definitely gonna be showing you some of my favorite vegan and plant-based items that I get from Aldi on the regular. Hold on. Look at this child right now. This is life. And make sure you stay tuned till the very end because I'm going to be showing you guys a recipe with a star item that just got brought to Aldi and I'm super excited about it. It is going to be a veganized recipe. We're gonna get ready and we're going to Aldi.
I try to never go grocery shopping without a grocery list. This tends to save us a lot when it comes to our monthly grocery expenses, as well as the headache of being in the middle of a recipe and not having an item. I'm not sure about you guys, but for me, if it's something that I use really often, you just kind of don't think about it as much. So when you do go to the grocery store and you're not prepared with a list, you tend to forget those necessity items. I actually have a whole video that shares my grocery list tips and how I go about making my grocery list. If you're interested in that, it'll be in the description below and I'll go ahead and put a link in the iCard. The iCard is going to pop up in your right hand corner. If you click on it, it'll send you directly to that video. If you are not interested in seeing this process of us getting ready and the shenanigans that we go through having four children all under 5 years old, you can skip straight to 3 minutes and 20 seconds and that'll start you right at our grocery haul. Or if you want to just watch the recipe for today, you can skip straight to 17 minutes and 17 seconds.
I'm doing makeup. I just got some lipstick, now I got some cheeks, and now I got some lips.
I have no idea. I just saw that in here today.
I
just
did too. I was so
alright, there you go. Hey, alright, did you finish your makeup?
That's a Crisco. Then pop it out. Cake. Bottom. It's okay, guys. It's just out on the ground. My favorite part about Aldi's is the Kinder Eggs. The Kinder Eggs too.
Your makeup is beautiful. All right, let's go. Welcome back from Aldi's. Now we will do a little bit of a haul. That was quite the experience. I'm exhausted right now. Daisy gets really car sick and she threw up as soon as we got in the Aldi parking lot. And then the girls wanted to go in with me and I had a huge list. So Frankie cleaned up the kids in the car while I took the big girls in. And then afterwards we all went to Chick-fil-A. So you know how exhausting Chick-fil-A is at 12 o'clock. I'm sure you're actually wondering what I got from Chick-fil-A. So I actually got, it's called a veggie wrap. And then of course I had waffle fries. And true confession here, I had the Chick-fil-A sauce with my waffle fries. It is what it is. Like I was already eating French fries and I was at Chick-fil-A, so I was having Chick-fil-A sauce. So let's jump into the grocery haul. I did pretty much categorize everything. Let's get started first with like the canned and glass goods. For canned and glass goods, I got salsa, two different types of salsas. We got some blueberry jelly, some a can of mixed vegetables, a can or a jar of avocado oil, ketchup, and this is no high fructose corn syrup ketchup. I have some diced tomatoes. These are fire roasted diced tomatoes, then regular diced tomatoes, and I got two cans in the back too. Garbanzo beans, 4 cans of that, 3 cans of green beans. I have some olives, some black beans, and this roasted garlic pasta sauce. Has no added oil or any sugar or anything like that either. So that was all of the canned and glass goods, and let me tell you, that was the heaviest bag for sure. The next thing that we will get into is all of our vegetables. For fresh fruits and vegetables, I have 2 things of cilantro, a bag of sweet potatoes, a 5-pound bag of yellow potatoes, 2 pounds of mushrooms, some onions, a bag of lemons, some carrots, a head of broccoli, some cabbage, pineapple, bananas, cantaloupe, cucumbers. We really like these little mini English cucumbers. They're perfect for like a 1 serving size, or if I'm making a salad, I don't have to cut up the whole thing. Some avocados, 3 avocados, a pack of corn, a pack of zucchini, a bag of kale, 2 heads of cauliflower, 2 mangoes, some Roma tomatoes, a pack of strawberries, a pack of blueberries, and a bag of cherries. The next category that we'll go through is going to be frozen goods. And this is something that, again, I like to stock up on vegetables with. So we will get our weekly groceries, and in the beginning of the week, I try to use all the fresh broccoli, the fresh cauliflower, the fresh mushrooms, all those kind of vegetables usually are in the beginning of the week. And then towards the end of the week, or if I'm making like a quicker meal and I don't really want to spend the time, that's when we will go into some of the frozen vegetables. So let's look at what we have for our freezer. Here are some of our staple freezers. Green beans, broccoli, spinach. I really like this little Asian medley. It has the little baby carrots in it, and it actually has a like an Asian seasoning pack that comes in it. That's not terribly bad. It does contain sugar and maltodextrin, so I'm not super crazy about that. So I usually just will add soy sauce, or if I have teriyaki, but if not, you could use that as well. And then some asparagus spears. And then these I pretty much keep on hand. These we usually will use as a breakfast option for us. So I'll make these as like breakfast potatoes for the kids, and then just cut up some fruit. These do have egg whites in it. So these are not vegan, and they also have canola oil. I'm not super happy about that. But other than that, it's got 7 ingredients. So, I mean, they're honestly not. These are actually great for like a quick needing something. So that is what we keep as our staple. Oh, also, I usually get peas and corn, but they just did not have those today. So yeah, that is our staples. Oh my gosh, I cannot say this. This is our freezer staples. And then the last 2 categories we'll look at are dry goods. Let's jump into those. So I named this category dry goods, even though obviously there's some wet stuff, but we'll start right here. Pineapple juice. These are not from concentrate. It's just straight pineapple, nothing else added. And I like to use these with smoothies. So I'll do half pineapple juice and half water, and it really just sweetens it up and takes away any bitter taste from any of the greens that I have in it. Almond milk. I have 3 of those. Some Mejil dates, eggs. Let's talk about the whole egg thing. We don't look at eggs as a health food. Like, I totally understand the amount of cholesterol that's in them, the fat that's in them, the protein that's in them, and how our body actually processes it. When I'm making a recipe and I want it to be healthy, I'm not gonna have eggs. Eggs for me are gonna be something that's like a cheat meal, or every once in a while. We are not 100% plant-based. We are striving towards that. We have been eating like this for about 1.5 years, almost 2 years now. I used to literally eat 2, sometimes 3 eggs every morning. Now I can buy 1 dozen eggs and it lasts 1.5 weeks. Part of this mindset change is just to help us eliminate some of the bad in our diet too, you know? So don't judge me. If you are plant-based and you see this, please don't be turned off. This channel is not about saying my way's right or your way's right. This channel is about just inspiring you with different recipes, and I can promise you that eggs will never be in any of my recipes because I don't want to promote them as a health food, okay? Okay, let's continue.
Next, we have some flax seeds, and I do actually grind some, like about half the bag up and put it in the freezer, and then I'll just put the other half like this. Rolled quick oats. I like the quick oats because we do eat them a lot raw, so they're just easier to eat like this. This was Emmy. Emmy had really wanted some pretzels today, and I let her get these. Again, these are not a health food, okay? Figs, I love figs. These are great for a snack. I honestly should have got probably two or three bags of these because I can just throw this in the diaper bag. They're not messy. The kids like them, I like them. They're sweet, they give you good energy, and I think like five of them is 100 calories, so they're awesome. These are great. Peanuts, I got salted dry roasted peanuts. I also got a thing of raisins. Again, we gotta be careful with those. That's a lot of sugar. I did get some lightly salted rice cakes, and I will take peanut butter and put it on here, maybe some chocolate chips and a little drizzle of maple syrup, and that would be like a sweet treat for me. Or I can go savory and mash up an avocado and put it on there, and that would be a quick breakfast. Another splurge, and also not vegan. Oh, these are vegan. Okay, well, here's a great example of why just because something's vegan does not make it healthy, okay? You see how there's like 900 words right there? And some of them you cannot pronounce. This to me means they're not healthy. But I brought my kids in the store with me and I told them they could pick out one thing each. Lila picks out this, Emmy picks out pretzels. Okay, bread. I love, 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 love this Italian bread. This is probably one of my favorites for my avocado toast. This is my favorite for croutons. This is my favorite for, I mean, this bread is just amazing. It doesn't have a lot of ingredients. Awesome. This is the bread that I keep on hand for like the kids, for peanut butter and jellies, if we're packing to go somewhere or whatever. The Great White, these breads are good, especially compared to this. This is bad, these are good, okay? It still is wheat and it still has gluten in it. And so it's something that you don't want, like you don't want to have toast for breakfast, a sandwich for lunch, and spaghetti with garlic bread for dinner, okay? These are still items. All of these items, really. The rice cakes, the bagels, the bread, the pretzels, the peanuts. These are all things, even the raisins. All of these things are things you want to eat in moderation, okay? So, again, another cheat. This was my cheat, okay? Potato chips. Veggie straws, this can be deceiving. Veggie straws, it really is just kind of like potato chips with a little bit of, I think it's tomato, spinach. Yeah, tomato and spinach for coloring. But they're not, these are better than some things, okay? A bag of sugar. This is just organic cane sugar. And then another one of my treats, the mesquite barbecue is my favorite.
Finally, the category that I am most excited about, and that is the cool plant-based and vegan options that we found. So let's start with the first thing that I found today, and this is a dairy-free sour cream. I am always looking for a sour cream substitute. Anytime you're getting these kind of substitutes, these are not super healthy. Like, these are just to get you by for something. So you still want the majority of your diet to come, like 80 or 90% of your diet to come from raw fruits and vegetables. But when like you just really want sour cream, but you don't want to like break what you've been doing, you look for options like this. And so I'm excited that those options are becoming available. If you are trying to go vegan or plant-based and you're looking for some really good protein options, edamame. And this is a steamable bag, so you can actually just microwave in this bag. Edamame is just the soybean. So it's still in its shell. It's like the whole pod, and you do not eat the outside. The very first time I got edamame, I tried to eat the whole thing and I was like, this is disgusting. I don't know why people eat this. I had no idea. And if you didn't know, you're welcome from saving you for that. The next thing is this dark chocolate and sea salt granola. This is delicious. Seriously, this is really good. If you like Starbucks, the seasonal chocolate caramel, no, salted chocolate caramel mocha dupe. I just found these today. I have actually not tried these, so I'm excited to try these as well. And it is these meatless chicken strips. They are soy protein and they do have maltodextrin, which is not great. Again, I'm not promoting this as this being super healthy. If you're really trying to just transition and you just don't know what to get, I'm just showing you that there are other options out there. And still, this doesn't have any cholesterol, any trans fats, anything like that. So it's still, in my opinion, is a little bit of a better option. The next thing, and I have had these, are these meat-free chicken tenders. I've had babysitters, and when they were here, I had these available for them, and they didn't even realize that it wasn't real chicken. They actually enjoyed it as well, so they're crowd pleasers. Vegan vegetable pot stickers. It's a rice and tapioca flour type dumpling, and you put a tiny bit of oil and a tiny bit of water in the bottom of a pan, and you just kind of steam these, but then when the water evaporates, they caramelize and get nice and crunchy on the bottom, so one side will be crunchy and crispy, and then they're like chewy, and then they're salty because they come with like this soy sauce dip, and these ones are all vegetables. And honestly, they really don't have, again, they do have xanthan gum, which is another one of those gums, which are not great for you. But these are not terrible, guys. These are a much better option than like going and grabbing fast food or something like that. And they're literally ready in 8 minutes. Are you guys ready for my most excited part? Dun, dun, dun. Beyond Meat, the Beyond Burger. It's a plant-based burger. That is what we are having for dinner, and I'm so excited that they have cool stuff like this at Aldi's just to like kind of give it a try. And even though these are not, like, again, not a staple in our house, these are great to have, throw in the freezer. If you're getting invited to a cookout, grab a pack, go to your cookout. You can even take the outside part off and it literally would look like a regular burger, and then you don't even have to hear it from nobody. You can just be like, oh, here's my burgers. So while this is cooking, I figured we could actually talk about what is in these burgers, because they do say plant-based burger patties. So the ingredients in this are water, pea protein, canola oil, coconut oil, and then it says less than 2% of the following, which is bamboo, potato starch, natural flavor, maltodextrin, yeast, salt, sunflower oil, dried yeast, gum, citrus extract, ascorbic acid, beet juice, acetic acid, and corn food starch, and then annatto for color. Okay, so these are good in the sense that it is pea protein versus soy. I get kind of really tired of like everything that's like a meat substitute being soy, but at the same time, when you take a product like the pea and you make a protein powder out of it, you're removing a lot of the different items out of it, and it kind of just goes back to not eating things processed. So this is definitely not like another healthy meal. I know, I feel like my whole thing today has been showing you all the unhealthy vegan stuff, but this is the reality that we live in, is that convenience is an issue for a lot of people, as well as just like certain flavors that you're wanting to like recreate. So I'm just showing you guys this as like different substitutes, as well as just ways that will help you to transition. For skillet, preheat pan to medium high heat and cook for 3 minutes per side. Do not overcook. Interior of the patty will be red or pink when fully cooked. So I watched a few different YouTubers actually make these, and like all of them looked like the insides were like really brown. So I've already taken them off. I just seared them. I actually went a little under 3 minutes because I am gonna be putting them back in the gravy.
I'm gonna make this recipe just as if I was making Salisbury steak. So the first thing that I did was I just went ahead and seared off both sides of the burgers. The directions said to go 3 minutes on each side, and I think I did about a minute and a half to 2 minutes on each side. Once it had a nice brown color, I just went ahead and took it off because I'm gonna finish cooking it in the gravy, so I'm not super worried about it being cooked all the way through right now. The next step that I did was I just kept all the oil and the juices from the patties in the pan, and I am using a cast iron skillet. I feel like this is the best way. But I just kept all the juices in the pan, and then I added in some mushrooms and onions. And my spice mix today is going to be black pepper, garlic powder, and salt. And I also have some all-purpose flour. Once all of my mushrooms and onions are caramelized and cooked all the way through, I'm going to add in the flour and let that cook out for about 2 minutes. Then I'll add in all of my seasoning. And then I will let that cook for a minute, and I did add in some soy sauce, and this just kind of helped with the coloring and adding in some more depth of flavor. Soy sauce has what they term as this umami flavor, which is a very meaty flavor. So then I went ahead and just added a little bit of water gradually until I had the thickness that I want. You want this to be, I mean, it's essentially just a pan gravy, so whatever your preference is here. And then I'm just gonna let that simmer away for about, I would say about 5 minutes. Once I'm satisfied with the consistency as well as the flavor of my gravy, I'm just gonna go ahead and add my burgers back to the gravy. And I'm going to let these simmer. I think I let them simmer for about 10 minutes. And during this process, I just took some of the gravy and actually topped the burgers as well to make sure that they were fully coated. And that was the whole process. I decided to serve this with some freshly steamed rice, and I'm sure I'm beating a dead horse when I say this to you again, but I do not do the standard ratio of rice to water, which is a 2-to-1 ratio. I do a 1-to-1 ratio, so 2 cups of rice, 2 cups of water. To go along with our Salisbury steak and rice, I did steam up some corn as well as some steamed up kale. To season up my kale, I just used a little bit of hot sauce and some maple syrup, and that was it. And of course, I have to show you what the center looks like. Yes, nice and pink. And stay tuned, and I will give you an honest review.
Good.
Did you try the meat?
Yep. I just did.
You like it? Did you try enemy? Try it.
I don't want to try the meat.
You don't? It's a hamburger.
I mean, it's hamburger meat. It's not real but meat. It's not real meat.
So it's a thumbs up for you, Lala? Yeah? You can't thumbs up. You haven't tried it.
No, thumbs up for corn.
So mad at your kids right now. All right, try this part first.
Ready? Very good.
It looks like raw hamburger, don't it?
It's very meaty.
It tastes like meat. It really is good though. I need some hot sauce.
It tastes like a hamburger steak.
That's what it's supposed to be, a Salisbury steak.
Salisbury steak, that's what I'm trying to say.
Oh, you nailed it! Really good. I thought I wasn't gonna like it because of the, on the box it said to cook it until, like, leave the center pink, and I thought I wasn't gonna like it because I thought it was gonna be mushy. But I think if I would have cooked it all the way through, it wouldn't have been as good. That is really good. It doesn't taste like a burger though.
It does to me.
Like, it has a smoky flavor, but it doesn't taste like a burger to me.
It has.
Like, it's sweeter. Right?
I think that's the gravy you're tasting this. I don't know.
It is pretty good. Okay.
Very good.
So, is it Frankie approved? Thank you again for watching. Be sure to subscribe. Hit the bell. That way you'll be notified when I post again, even though you know it's gonna be on Wednesday. Just don't want you to forget. I will see you next Wednesday.
What do I do, Mommy?